you. Thank you for coming. This morning when I woke up, turned on radio 4, and what I heard was, well, at last it's here, it's arrived, this momentous occasion, you know, this massive overlay of social media, and I thought, wow, they've heard about the child's But of course, there is something else happening today. Following up from that, there was also a little commentary about what was going on at M&S, where the chief executive of M&S was saying, oh, well, we're not really delivering what customers are buying, essentially. We've got all these wonderful things, all these wonderful products, but these really are not buying them. And then we had this wonderful discussion, so I think there's a panel out here. Anyway, on we went, the usual stuff about M&S, underwear and cake and sticky toffee. And I thought, right, okay. And then I said, well, what we're actually going to do is reduce the number of stores, but we're going to deliver more. And I thought, that's, you know, the two things that come on the radio, I think, yes, they both relate to the charts. One, we're getting information out there, but two, there is a need for change, and we're on the direction of change with interventions, health and social care. That is not just affecting health, social care as we know it, the whole economy is changing, and the way that we live and receive services. So when M&S, the M&S chief executive, sorry if I've got any services, we're actually going to have less service opportunities for you to go in price, but we're actually going to get more funds in terms of value. And everything, that's where we are. And that's the challenge that we have with the charity. At the moment we're working with organisations who are friendly to us. You know, let's be honest here, we're working with organisations that know the direction of challenge, appreciate the challenges that we all face collectively, and understand at the end of the day that if we don't do something now, we're all going to be, producing an analogy to stick it to the body, but swimming treat. And so in terms of moving on, I think one of the things our challenge is to work with the partners that we've identified to actually achieve the change that we want to see the carers. In fact, I'll go back a bit because I don't want to let go to that section first. I want to tell you a little bit more about me. I was a working carer, but I was one of the people that wouldn't say, hello, I'm a carer. And some of you might know from 10, maybe 15 or more years ago, when I worked for a generation of care fees. And it was interesting then, we were talking about how can we join up services, particularly as it affected the third sector. But how can we join up services so that people don't fall between cracks, communities feel supported and engaged. And, you know, there was me, you know, working all the hours that were available, that God sent. And there were times when I just disappeared off the radar. And that was because I was caring. But it was also in the periods when I was at my most productive. And do you know why? That was because I worked in an environment and a company that said, oh, okay, we understand that from time to time you're just going to have to drop everything and go. You know, but there's no sense of, oh dear, look at the watch. It was just do what you have to do. And as a result, my commitment was not coming. It was, you couldn't rate it on a scale. Yes, when it came down to it, I'd be working, start work at 8, and sometimes we'd be finishing the meeting with 3 to 4 at 9 o'clock. But that was great because I felt satisfied, I felt I could achieve something. And I knew that when I had to go and to my daughter, that the time would be given, no questions asked, and my colleagues felt safe and saying, hello, Portia. How's your daughter? How's Mum? Is she okay? And that, to me, was worth so much. I can't express to you how valuable that support that I gave from my employer was. So in terms of moving forward, yes, we have challenges, but we have opportunities. And I'd like you to think, if you're an employee organisation, if it possibly not, think about who are the most productive people in your organisation, who might be most committed. And you'll probably find that the ones that are resilient and creative are the ones that have actually got to manage care and responsibilities in the moment. Now, if you support them, just think how much further, more potential you could realise within your organisation. And the outcomes that we have, not just for you, but for carers. Neil's already explained and explored the whole NHS commitment to carers and why it's so important. I think because you're here, you understand and you get that. So what I'd like to do now is say thank you to all of you who are on this journey with us. And in no particular order, just to highlight who some of you are. We've got the CCGs, we've got the council, or well, I know you can read it, but just reference the fact that we've got major care delivery organisations involved. And the university, who are there not just as employers of the receivers of thousands of students into middle school, but they're there because they're also going to help us with our evaluation program. One of the key things that we need to do, and evidence for you as well, is the impact of the child. What difference will it actually make? We can talk and say how wonderful this is. We can tell, you know, we could probably sell coals to Newcastle if this will give impact the ground. But what's really going to make a difference is having validated evidence that says this is the difference that it can make to your organisation and society as a whole. And then we've got also got moving to the first sector, not just really police and all that one. But we've also got to look at the wide perspective, who else is delivering support to care. And again, we've got a range of organisations here who are going to help us on this journey. We don't know the answers, we don't know all the answers as yet, but by working with you, as part of the sets, on a collaborative basis, we believe that we can make a difference, we can make change happen, and we can create the care of the community and the community. That workshop is the carer's charity. And thank you for your involvement and your ongoing engagement. We will be coming back to you and making demands of you, but hopefully demands that you'll feel, yeah, that was a bit of it to make. One of the things we want are volunteers. We actually need more people to support us on this journey. So we've got charter champions, but we also want people who are prepared to help us along the way. So it might be yourself, it might be people in your organisation, your colleagues, your friends. Please, come on this journey with us and let's support the Carers Charity. Thank you very much.